crunch, there's a cliched saying that a person who is failing to plan is planning to fail. Though a cliched saying, but it holds very true to UPSC. If a person is not planned in terms of his study, he is bound to fail in this particular exam. And for this, you need a very planned strategy and a planned program. But you might have seen that there are 100 number of programs in the market. And in this entire brouhaha of programs, people are, UPSC aspirants are getting confused. So what has happened over a period of time that with different number of programs, the UPSC way of studying has been lost. It has become an institute's way of studying. Keeping all this in mind, the Manifest team have brought out a new course which is called Instruction Assessment Guidance Program 2020, that is IAG program. Now what exactly, how is this different from other programs? What is its importance? What are we trying to do differently? Keeping in mind the dynamics and the changing nature of the exam. IAG program 2020 is a product of long deliberation, looking after the different programs in the market which have failed, and we have learned from that. And through this learning process, we have brought out this program. Now basically, if you look at this program, consists of three components. It is instruction, second component is assessment, and third is guidance. The first component is instruction. With respect to instruction in our program refers to classes. Classes constitute an integral component of this particular course. There are around 600 hours of classes which will cover word to word of both prelims and main syllabus. Now the classes will start in June, the program will start in June, the classes will start on June 17th. Now with respect to the classes, I'll give you the important features of the classes. First, classes will cover the entire syllabus. Many a times what happens, aspirants do not read the syllabus, they go after books. But this program has been designed specifically keeping syllabus in mind. For example, in polity, many just read Lakshmikant, but there are certain things which are beyond Lakshmikant, which are indirectly mentioned in the syllabus. For example, delimitation commission, which was not earlier included in Lakshmikant, or PIL, which has been later added to Lakshmikant, all these will be covered in class. So going beyond books, sticking to syllabus is our motto in this program. Second thing, in the classes, from basics to higher level concepts will be discussed. So why this is done? Many a times it happens that in a particular class you find people from different backgrounds. So the demands of different students is different. So a person who is a beginner needs basic concepts. A person might not be knowing what is constitution itself. But there will be certain candidates who are also of the higher level who already have done a basic reading of different textbooks. This program will be useful for both, because we are moving from basics to the highest level of the concepts, which are beyond books as well, which are necessary for UPSC. So even a person who has been preparing for this exam for the past 2-3 years will also gain help from the classes. And other than that, the beginner also will be in the right environment, because the basic concepts also will be laid in the class. Third important thing is current affairs linkage. Most aspirants fail in understanding that current affairs is not an independent discipline in itself. Current affairs is not mentioned separately in anywhere in mains, it has been mentioned in prelims. So what does this exactly mean? It should not be studied as an independent discipline. Every particular chunk has its own current affairs part. Keeping this in mind, every class will cover a current affairs aspect of it. For instance, if the polity classes are running, polity current affairs of that particular week or that particular month will be integrated with the classes. Now you might question that what will be done for those current affairs topics which will appear later than the topic which is already dealt in the class. For that, extra classes will be taken and then it will be integrated. Finally, coming to the most important part of the classes, we are starting a new kind of class called avant-garde classes. What are these avant-garde classes? Many a times you have seen that a person who is a university champ, who is a gold medalist or a topper in university, doesn't many a times he or she fails to qualify this exam because this particular exam demands a different kind of bent of mind. University approach is completely different from UPSC. What Manifest believes is in a UPSC way of studying. These avant-garde classes are extra classes which are spread over the year. In these classes, we'll be teaching you what exactly is UPSC. This will be more helpful or most helpful for those candidates who have already given attempts. And it will build a kind of UPSC mode into their preparation. Like for instance, many people do not focus on government sites. Many people do not focus on government books. Many people do not focus on government related facts. They mostly study compilations, etc. How to avoid this? How to take the best use or how to mold yourself to UPSC way is what is taught in avant-garde classes. Next, now coming to the techniques of teaching in classes. With respect to the techniques of teaching, we believe in a chunk-wise method. That is, if a particular section of the subject has to be completed in a particular period of time, if continuous shifting of subjects occurs, polity after economy after that, international affairs, there will be no proper linkage established. So a chunk-wise method is followed. Most importantly, we are following a technique called thematic integration. If you look at different subjects in GS, social justice is there in polity. Social justice is also there in Indian society. And Indian social history of India is also there in history. So all these three things have to be studied together so that the students get a better linkage. Now, if you look at our timetable, you will see that social history of ancient India, medieval India, modern India, once it is done, immediately society portions of Indian society will start. Now, Indian society part, where we study social empowerment and social justice, that will be linked to DPSP in Indian polity. Now, what is the importance of this? You should have an integrated view of the syllabus. This will help in writing interdisciplinary answers, which will fetch more marks. You have been seeing that many questions which were never expected in geography to be asked, they are being asked. For example, in regional navigation satellite system, which was asked recently, it's a science and tech question. But this has been asked in geography. What does this mean? This is showing that UPSC doesn't recognize the difference between subjects. It is trying to bring interdisciplinary linkages. In order to build this interdisciplinary approach itself, we are placing classes in such a way that there are cross integrations or cross disciplinary linkages are built. I'll give you one more example. For instance, if you start polity, before starting polity, you will be having classes related to political history of ancient, medieval and modern India, and you'll also be studying 1773 to 1947 by the history teacher, who is an expert or specialized in this particular topic. Immediately after that, polity classes are placed. So cross-disciplinary linkages are established. Even if you look at ethics also, if you see ethics has a four-part integration, four-part bifurcation we have done. For ethics has PBAD related issues, which is linked with governance. Ethics has economics related issues, which is linked with economy. Ethics has thinker related issues. So ethics has psychology related issues as well. So when you look at this bifurcation, these will be linked with those particular subjects only. Why? A better integration, better in terms of writing answers also, and better fetching of marks. So this is the component of instruction, that is classes. Now, just classes don't clear this or will not help in clearing the exam. Tests or evaluation or your assessment of your gaining of knowledge is also important. Keeping this in mind, tests, we have three categories of test. One kind of test is called sprint test. So what is a sprint test? After the sprint tests are these are class tests, these are daily tests, these are given at the end of the class. Now, you have to understand this concept. Sprint tests are questions which are not directly 12 and a half marks. They are short note questions, maybe 5 marker questions. These will be given on the next day of the class. For instance, if you have a class on day 1, on day 2, you'll be having the portions related to day 1, and on day 2, you're writing the sprint test. Now, what is the importance of this? Why exactly we are doing this way? One important thing of sprint test is it is based on block building method. A student immediately after joining the course or who is not in the mode of UPSC cannot write a 12.5 mark answer. Even if he writes it, it will be a university approach. What he needs is a specialized training in terms of answer writing, and it cannot directly jump to 12.5 mark as well. So keeping that in mind, we are developing a block building method wherein 5 markers will be given first on a daily basis. Second thing, with respect to sprint test, it is based on post readings. What is post readings? You won't be having the test through pre readings, that is, you read first, then you have a test. No, it is not that way. Suppose sprint test of day 2 we consider, the portions of day 1 will be there. What it includes? It includes your class lecture, it will include some of the chapters of the standard books. Now, why are we not giving readings before the class? Because a student doesn't know how to read at a particular textbook. There is a UPSC method of reading textbook. And if the student doesn't reads it prior to the class itself, most of the times the person goes wrong. In order to avoid this mistake, the readings will be given once the class lecture on the particular topic is done. It is only after that the sprint test will be conducted on a regular basis. This will keep you in the mode of writing as well. Now, sprint test, after the end of the class, once the test is done, the model answers will be discussed in the class, and these are checked through peer evaluation. Now, coming to the main test. Now, the entire program has spaced prelims and main test. Prelims test, there are total 41 in number, which includes 8 CSAT tests as well. Now, prelims test, how they are integrated. Prelims test, the importance, need to know two important features with respect to this. After a chunk is completed, you get a specific time period for revision. Usually Saturdays are given holidays to study for prelims test. And at every regular interval, you have a revision test also. Suppose you complete 1.5 months of preparation, you have given, suppose, 2-3 tests. There is a tendency to forget those past three test portions. So at regular intervals, there are revision tests also. Because remember this thing, in UPSC, without revision, it is not going to happen. Precisely because it is said that a book should be read 100 times rather than reading 100 books at a time. Now, coming to the mains test, overall mains test, 12 tests, there are 12 tests. And with respect to the main test, there are 4 essay tests, 2 ethics, and 6 GS tests. Now, how these are spaced? These are again linked with your classes, these are linked with your prelims. So suppose you have a chunk of polity, then you have prelims tests, you'll be having main tests only on those sections. So there will be a proper integration between your classes and also the main tests. So and whenever a main test is conducted, that entire week is given free for you to revise and then attempt this test. Most importantly, all these papers will be evaluated and also discussed. Evaluation, we have a unique method of part-wise evaluation, which will help in developing a UPSC way in the students. They can see for themselves where they are going wrong. To know more about our part-wise evaluation, you can visit our website and watch Manifest vlog. Now, coming to the last part of the program, that is guidance. Students might have classes, student might have tests, student might have been assessed, but UPS is a long process. It doesn't end in a day or two. It's a very long process. So due to this, there is a need of constant pushing and motivation by the teachers. Many a times, the graph usually is what? Initially, there will be a huge pep, and then in the middle, it goes down. So here, the role of a teacher becomes important, where we have to push the students, and that is why this guidance component is there. What is guidance component? Here we are given appointments with the expert teachers or the expertise in those subjects. You can, through the technology mediated appointments, you can book an appointment. You need not wait for the teacher. And it is not just for motivation, it is also for all kinds of doubt clearance. Despite classes, despite tests, students will still be having doubts, specified personalized doubts with respect to their preparation. All will be taken care in this particular component called guidance. So it is an integrated program which consists of instruction, assessment, and guidance. And with respect to when does it start, it starts on June 17th, and June 17th is an open session. We welcome you all. And for more details of the program, you can visit the website and download the timetable. Thank you.